There is a question. Swamiji, is it possible to live without mind? I am replying, look at here. Here is a person sitting with flesh and bones. I am living without mind. I have no vested interest to convince you. Accept the simple courtesy. Accept the simple courtesy. I don't even want to give a big word, compassion. No. Who am I? I don't even want to give a big word, compassion. For example, you are traveling in Mysore Road. You are near Bangalore. Somebody from Bidadi is ringing up and asking you, how is the traffic? I wanted to come to Bangalore. How long do you think it will take? Will you not have a simple courtesy to guide them through cell phone? No, don't bother. Road is clear. In 10 minutes you can reach, or 20 minutes you can reach. You will not have a simple courtesy. I tell you from the same simple courtesy, you can live without mind. There is a new mental setup, new way of life, new way of existing is possible, which I say, living without boundaries. Living without boundaries. Just let your ball roll with your life. Go and live. Do play the whole game. But don't think it is for your survival sake. It is for your survival sake. Don't think it is for your survival sake. Somebody asked Ravana Maharishi, Bhagavan, I wanted to come and settle down in Tiruvannamalai. Bhagavan says, do it. Then after a few days he comes and says, Bhagavan, I did calculation. For me to survive in Tiruvannamalai, 6 rupees is more than enough. In those days, 6 rupees is more than enough. Bhagavan laughs and says, fool, for you to survive, you don't even need body and mind. Why do you need 6 rupees? For you to survive, you don't even need body and mind. Why do you need 6 rupees? We always think, only with the survival of the body and mind you can survive. It is the other way. You don't even need your body and mind. The moment you understand, you don't even need your body and mind. It is such a big freedom. See now, what for your all this suffering? Tell me. For food and the basic facility. If you die, you are free from that responsibility. You are free from that responsibility. You are free from that headache. Now, all our struggle is for these 2-3 things. One is food and basic facility. And for comfort, and for name and fame, what others will think about me. This all. If you die, you are free from all this responsibility. It's almost like yeah, you yourself. The very poor one and the people to Kodai, Kodai, and so on. But how to translate that into English? That some chameleon. All right, some lizard which was in the fence, this guy picked up the lizard and put inside his breast and he started claiming, oh, it is hurting. Why do you first of all bring that lizard into your clothes? Then you start shouting, oh, this is doing something here. The very basic thing, even if you die, it's a big freedom from responsibility. The moment you understand death as a liberation, you are free from the whole thing. Your ego disappears. The moment you understand death as a liberation, your Ajna opens, your ego disappears. You enter into Varanasi. That is why in Varanasi, death is liberation and celebration. When they say death is liberation in Varanasi, they mean if you enter into Varanasi, egoless state, death is liberation. Now, life is a big responsibility. Death is a big liberation. Death is big liberation. The moment you understand death is a liberation, life becomes celebration. You don't have responsibility. Responsibility is the idiotic word, according to me.
Swami, unfulfilled duties. Of course, you were saying it is your ego which is showing that.
See, what is duty? Tell me.
No, if our children are there and they have to be provided for, so suddenly
you think,
if we...
You think that if you provide for them, they will be happy?
No, at least the minimum, so that they are able to...
All right, you, all minimum has been provided to you. Are you happy?
At least I am not unhappy.
Okay, all right. When will you think that your responsibility will end?
Once they are settled, educated and settled.
You think that your responsibility will end?
Hopefully so.
From my experience, let me be very clear. I have seen lakhs of people, even after their death, they don't feel their responsibility has ended. That is why they write will. Why do you think we write will? Even after death, we don't want to end our responsibilities. Actually, the moment you associate yourself with some responsibility or duty, even after death, you can't relax. You'll be watching from somewhere. Whether these guys have fulfilled my will or not, I don't know. Whether they have done according to their will or according to my will. So the responsibility never ends, even after you die. The moment you associate yourself with the duty consciousness, a responsibility, you will never end. It will never end. It is an unending vicious circle. In my experience, I have not seen a single person who feels he has finished his responsibilities, who feels he has finished his duties. It is a cunning word to cover your selfish enjoyment motives. Be very clear. All your word duty, responsibility is a beautiful cover. It's a beautiful cover to cover your selfish desires and for desires towards enjoyment. Some corner, and even your so-called children's responsibility, it is actually once your body is tired and weak, once you are not able to enjoy, you enjoy through your children. They are the extension of your being. Just understand. If they don't listen to your words and take their own decisions, will you feel responsible? Will you feel that it's your duty? Then what happens to all your duty and responsibility? If it is really responsibility and truth, duty, according to truth, you are supposed to be responsible at any time, whatever they do. But do you feel responsible if they do on their own? Do you feel? No. Then what happens? Means all your word, duty, responsibility, everything is taking care of them for your own, as you see, as long as they act as your own extension, you take care of them. They are your extension. You feel satisfied through them. You enjoy through them. When you feel, I can't enjoy anymore, what to do? Then you think, all right, let this guy enjoy at least. Let this guy have. You feel happy. You see, my son has got a big car. My son has got a big house. Again, my son has got big house. Means what? I have big house with little alteration. The same statement with little alteration. Some enjoy the I, the others enjoy the mind. That's all. As long as you have power, you enjoy the I. The moment you are a little weak, you start enjoying the mind. Power through others. All your sense of responsibility, idea of duty, is nothing but extension of selfish desires to some joy, some enjoyment. So you give a beautiful cover. You cannot be so abrupt, straight. Because you know the basic lesson, selfishness is wrong. So now you have to find some cunning word to hide it, to cover it, to play the hide and seek game. Now what is the game? What is the next word? No, no, no. Dharma. We have a big word, dharma. What do we know about dharma? Nothing. What we do? Actually, nothing. Many times I have seen people who feel they have duty towards their children, they destroy the children's life. They neither allow the kids to marry on their own, nor they allow the kids to live the life the son or daughter wants. The daughter wants to live alone, happily, without getting married. But the father, mother says, no, 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 we have the responsibility to put you in marriage. It's our duty. Son wants to go, become a doctor. Father says, no, 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 you have to become engineer. I have the responsibility to make you as engineer. The guy wants to do operation. If he becomes engineer, what will happen? Somebody wants to be engineer. They say, no, 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 you can make money only as a doctor. Come here, we will put you as a doctor. This guy wants to break stones. If he's made as a doctor, what will happen? He'll be breaking the heads. So, when you all idea about duty consciousness is nothing but your own selfish desires with a little bit of gold covering. It is just gold covering, nothing else. Jewelry with gold covering. Problem is, the jewelry is not even made of copper, it is made of mud and gold coated. Jewelry gold coated, made by mud, is what? Is our concept of duty and responsibility. All your duty, all your idea of responsibility, as long as it is from fear and greed, it will create only more worrying. You will have the continuous irritation and weight in the mula, in the Manipurana. In this region, you will have a continuous weight, continuous irritation. Suddenly, one day, decide and drop everything. Simply drop everything. Just let go. Just get ready. Even if death comes, okay, I am not going to do anything. Let go. Drop and relax. Simply within few days, a tremendous understanding will dawn on you. Nothing can touch you. Nothing can touch you. Even death is a liberation. That is what I say by the word death experience. I don't mean death experience means you will have something different. This cognitive shift. Even if I die, what is there? I am free from all these responsibilities and headaches. So death is only a liberation. First of all, people come and ask me, if I die, what will happen? As if what you are living, how you are living now, tell me. What's your life? Just do a little bit of research. You see one thing. If you had some experience, great experience, and you want that experience to repeat in your life, if you are living for that, then okay. Can you say any one experience, just for that experience to repeat, I am living? Is there anything worthy which has happened in our life? Just look back for that one worthy incident only, worthy experience. Life is worth living. I am just hoping it may repeat once more in my life. That is the reason I am still alive. Can we say even a single experience like that? No. There is nothing like that. If you scan your life, anything worthy? Okay. Okay. And then why do you want to then leave? If you scan also, you say it is filled with worries and difficulties and problems. And you want to leave also. It's like a vicious circle. You create fear based on the question of survival, and after the fear, again you want to survive. It's like you create a fence and go out, hit yourself in the fence and you want to break the fence and go out. Alright, first of all, there is no fence. Why do you create? And then go and hit yourself and you wanted to go out. Understand this basic secret about death. as long as you live, play the drama. The moment death comes, relax, enjoy, over. Just this simple understanding how death will simply liberate you.